So this is part two of my tutorial on data converters. This time we're going to talk about the opposite conversion, that is digital to analog converters. Okay, I'm going to talk about one D2A converter. D2A converter is short for digital to analog. Okay, so what you see here is an R2R ladder, and this network is actually the central component of the digital to analog converter I'm going to show you. Again, you'll see a simulation on CircuitLab, just like the analog to digital case. So first let's study this converter. Okay, so the special thing about this converter is if you look at any network, okay, so if you look through, let's say, this network, okay, if you look through this, you will actually see 2 R's of resistance, because imagine all of these are grounded for now. Okay, imagine all of these are grounded for now. So if you look through this, you will see 2R and 2R in parallel, which gives me R, but then you have an R over here in series, so you get 2R. Okay, you remember that the equivalent of this is 2R, 2R and 2R in parallel, again that is in series with R, so you get 2R. So you look at any mesh, you'll always get a 2R. Even here you obviously have 2R. So that's one special property of this circuit. And the way this circuit works is you construct this circuit, and you give your MSB here. Okay, so you get either 5 volts or 0 volts here. You give the second bit here, the third bit here, and the LSB over here. Okay, and depending on what binary value you have, suppose you have 1000, you'll have the appropriate value at the output, and this is V output. Okay, this is V output. And how do you get the value of V output? The formula is pretty straightforward. Suppose your value is V. Okay, so it can vary from, since this is a 4-bit network, it can vary from 0 to 15. V divided by 2 power n. Okay, n over here is 4, so 2 power n would be 16, times V reference. Okay, and V reference is, we've studied that in 6002x. V reference is, you know, the maximum is the value of 1. Okay, so digital 1 would be probably 5 volts, so V reference is 5 volts. Okay, depends on the technology you use. Okay, so let me just zoom, increase my canvas size. Okay, so suppose we had a value of 10. 10 corresponds to a V of 2. Okay, binary 10 is 2 in decimal, so 2 divided by 2 power n is 15, times, suppose my V reference is 5, 2 power 16, so okay, it would give me a 5 by 8. Okay, which is equal to 0.625. and in the simulation you will see we get an approximate value of 0.625. so how do we get this value? How is it possible? So we'll do an analysis. It's not very straightforward. You need to do node method. Okay, that's the only way I could think of. Brute force node method is the only way to analyze the circuit, and we'll just do that. I'll do this for two examples. I'll do it for 1000 and I'll do it for 0010. 1000 is quite straightforward. This is 1, so since this is 1, this is grounded, this is grounded, this is grounded. Okay, and we can mentally solve this circuit. So 2R and 2R are in this 2R and this 2R in parallel, so you get an R. This R and this are in series, you get 2R. This and this are again in parallel, so you get R again. R and R gives me 2R. 2R and 2R gives me R again in parallel, and then I get 2R over here. So in the end, okay, so let me just undo all of that. In the end, you actually see a 2R over here, okay, and you see a 2R over here, right? This is equal to 5 volts, this is 0 volts, and I need the voltage over here. This is a simple voltage divider network. You know that the voltage over this would be 2.5. So this makes sense, because 1000 is the halfway value, right? It's 8. Okay, 8 is like the halfway point, and you should obviously get half the value of the reference voltage when we give D3 equal to 1 and D2 down to 0 is 0. Okay, that was simple. Let's look at the case when it's equal to 2, and we'll need to work out a little bit in that case. So just to make things simple, I'm going to consider resistance of just one ohm. So this will be 2 ohms and this will be 1 ohms. Okay, just to make things simple, make my calculation simple, you will see that the R anyway gets cancelled out, so it doesn't matter. Okay, what matters is the values. The value over here is always twice the value over here. That's all that matters. Okay, so let's actually analyze this circuit. So let me just erase all this off quickly. And what do I have? I have this equal to 5 volts. Okay, and all of these are grounded. Okay, and before we actually use, so I want E1, this is E2, and this is E3. And if you again quickly notice, this is 2 and 2 in parallel gives me 1, and 1 and 1 in series gives me 1. So I can replace this with a simple wire. I can ignore this, and we have the same network. Okay, so this is simple. And let me just quickly write down the node equations. Okay, so the node equations for the first node, E1 node, is E1 times 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 minus E2 times 1 equals 5 by 2. Okay, I'm not going to tell you how I got the equations. This is already done in 6002x. Okay, node method. Okay, so if I simplify this, I get 2 times E1 minus E2 equals 2.5. Okay, this is my first equation. The next, the second node, E2, if I write equations for that, I get minus E1 plus half plus 1 plus 1 times E2 minus E3 equals to 0. If I simplify this, I get minus E1 plus 2.5 E2, okay, minus E3 equals 0. This is my second equation. And my third and final equation would be minus E2, okay, plus 1 plus half times E3 equals 0. And if I simplify this, I get minus E2 plus 1.5 times E3 equals to 0. And this is my third equation, okay. And if I solve for these, I get E1 equal to some value, which is not really important because we don't want this value. We get E2 equal to 15 by 16, okay. The last one's important. We get E3 equal to 5 by 8, and this is exactly the value we just calculated, so 0.625, right? And so you can see that this network works. So if you want, you can check, you can do node analysis for all 0 to 15, or you could actually derive the general equation which I showed you, and you could do that as an exercise. So let's look at the actual circuit. I've added a few more components to the actual circuit, okay? So this is the entire circuit. The circuit you see below is actually a counter. Okay, it's not the simpler. It may not be the simplest circuit, but this was the only way I could do it without using pen and paper. Okay, so what you see here is actually an up down counter. Okay, it's a counter which can count one as well as up, depending on what value you give here. If you give a value of one over here, you can see this T out, right? If you give a value of 1 over here, it'll act like an up counter. So an up counter counts from 0 to n minus 1, okay? And then it rolls back to 0 and then counts. So it'll count, let's say, so this will count from 0 to 15 and then go back to 0 and then 0 to 15 and then go back to 0. A down counter, okay, so suppose this T out is 0, okay, then it would be a down counter. So it'll count 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. And then it'll go back to 15 and then back to 0, okay? So that's the counter. I added a little bit of extra circuitry. So what this does is I used a T flip flop, a toggle flip flop, and whenever the output of this is 1111, whenever it is 15, okay, this T flip flop will toggle this output. It'll go back to 0. So so the direction of counting would change. So when it reaches 0, it'll transform into a down counter, okay, and when it reaches 0. Okay, you can see this, when it reaches 0, it will transform into an up counter. So in effect, what my counter will count from 0 to 15, then back from 15 to 0, then 0 to 15, and then back from 15 to 0, okay? And you'll see why I've done that, okay, when you see the output of the DAC. This is my DAC, this is my D2A converter. And let me zoom in for you. You can see the ladder network over here. What you see here is just a simple voltage follower, just so that my next stage, okay, this so that this stage does not load my R2R ladder, okay. So it's a voltage follower. If you want some amplification, you can add the correct resistor divider network, and you can create a non-inverting amplifier. Okay, that's up to you. The second circuit you see over here is a filter, okay? So I want to, you will see why I'll need a filter. So it will actually smoothen the output, okay? So let's actually see the output of this circuit. So let me do hide that. Something's okay. I added some extra outputs. Okay, let me run the simulation again. Okay, so you can see here, you know, you get the step output. So this is the output of the R2R ladder. Okay, if I hide this, this is actually the output of this. It's step out. Okay, so you can see this is V step out, and you can see why I actually added that extra circuitry. So you can get, so you get 0 to 15 and then goes back to 0, you get 0 to 15, so I get something like a triangular output. And you can see what the filter did as well. So it actually it smoothened out these steps. Okay, these steps are actually high frequency components. They are components of, I guess, hang on. They are components of 1 kilohertz. Okay, my clock is 1 kilohertz, so these steps are 1 kilohertz components. But this is about, I guess, 1/30, so 1/30 milliseconds. So this is a low frequency, and this is a high frequency. So I've used a low pass filter to filter out these high components, and you can see I get these smooth waveforms. Below this, you can see the counter output, not very important, but like you can see, I've converted from digital. Okay, these are all my digital outputs to analog. Okay, so this is digital analog conversion. There are other circuits as well. What you see here is a voltage R2R ladder. You have current R2R ladders as well. There are many more complicated circuits. You have switch capacitor circuits and many more. The advantage of the R2R ladder network is in VLSI circuits, in chips. Okay. It's not easy to actually have an exact value of 100 and 200, but it is very easy to have a value of R and 2R. So it doesn't matter. The advantage of the R2R ladder is it doesn't matter what the value of R is. What matters is you should have double the resistance here and double of this resistance over here, and that's easy to achieve in a fabrication system. So that's an R2R ladder network. And what you see here is another connection between 6002X and signals and systems, and you also see a connection between the analog domain and the digital domain in a real circuit. Okay, so that's it for this tutorial.